Hello and welcome to Dateline. I'm Jana Wendt. Tonight, a special report. As the leaders of the two Koreas banquet in the North Korean capital, Pyongyang, we go undercover to film the secret lives of North Korean refugees hiding in China. The refugees are part of an exodus of starving families who've crossed illegally into neighboring China in a desperate search for food.
The mountains of northeast China. An hour's walk into these forests, a family is living in hiding, under the earth. Kim Gansu and Kim Young-hee dug this hole themselves and have been hiding from police here with their young son for the past 4 months. Their crime, in the eyes of China and North Korea, is simply that they left their famine-stricken homeland to look for food. This is their fourth hideout in the mountains since they started that journey. Even here, surrounded by caution and living in fear, they tried to keep some sense of a normal family life. Chinese police are paid a bounty to capture refugees like this and return them to North Korea. The Kims know that if they're sent back, they'll be labeled as traitors and put to death. The underground hideout is only a few kilometers from the North Korean border the Kims crossed illegally just over a year ago. When the Kim family first came to China, they had three children and Young-hee was pregnant with a fourth. But hiding in the forest isn't easy with a young family, and one by one, they've had to give their children away. But the breakup of the family has been traumatic, and Young Shin has now taken to the cheeky habit of puffing on his father's cigarettes. In the morning, the Kims prepare to leave their dugout for a journey down the mountain to visit the daughters they handed to the orphanage 4 months ago.
Our 작은 데가 떨어졌습니다. 작기.